All right, so now we go back once more to whomever can sign customs documents, CBP documents for drawbacks. And basically you have a list of entities and you have columns which says, okay, those guys can sign this and this, but those guys can only sign those documents, all right? So pretty much you see the usual list of individuals and persons who can sign. So president, vice president, secretary, treasurer, or any other employee. So those guys are by default because they're officers of the company. We're talking about corporation or employee that is legally authorized to bind the corporation by, and this can be done by resolution or by some kind of power of attorney form. A full partner, all in partnership. So if it's a limited partner, there can be an issue if that limited partner is not, if his limitation does not cover the scope of customs business, so that will not do. The owner of a sole proprietorship, if one is engaging in drawback, right, the owner doing drawback for himself or herself also qualifies, all right? And here we're talking about drawback entry, certificate of delivery related to drawback entry, other certificates and supporting documentation. Individual action on his or her own behalf, which is pretty much this guy, right? Well, it can also be attributable to the company. A licensed customs broker with a power of attorney. So with a power of attorney, recall that for to engage in customs business, you have to have three things if you're going to engage in customs business as a customs broker. First, you have to have the license, either corporate or individual. Second, you have to have a permit. Third, you have to have a power of attorney. What about the permit? What about the permit for licensed customs broker as far as drawback is concerned? So the first question we have to ask is, does drawback constitute a customs business? And the answer is, located in definitions 111.1, which pretty much define customs business. And yes, drawback or those duties or preparation of drawback or activities relating to preparation of drawback is customs business. So that's a goal, right? So since it is customs business, then the drawback is customs business. So if you're doing it as a customs broker, then you have to have those three things. You have to have a permit, you have to have a power of attorney. But we saw that there is only like four ports who are doing drawback. So does it mean that let's say you are somewhere in Anchorage, Alaska, you have a permit to conduct customs business in Anchorage, Alaska? Does it mean that you have to get another permit? Well, the answer, you don't have to venture out too far to get that answer. So this was 111.2 license and district permit required, right? For filing drawback claims, a broker granted a permit for one district may file drawback claims manually or electronically at the drawback office that has been designated by customs. So we're talking about those four ports for the purpose of filing drawback claims, and may represent his client before that office in matters concerning those claims, even though the broker does not have a permit for the district in which the drawback office is located. In other words, no. If you are a licensed customs broker engaging in customs business in Anchorage, Alaska, you do not need to file to get a permit in one of those four ports which have the drawback office locations. So in other words, you do not need to get the guy in Alaska or the lady in Alaska does not, they do not have to apply for the permit in those ports for to file drawback. Just the fact that they have a permit in Anchorage will do. That's for the drawback. So the drawback is kind of an exception, right, to the permit, the general permit rule. What about the power of attorney? Is there such an exception to the power of attorney? So powers of attorney, they're found in part 141, right? Subpart C. So this is the general rule which applies to pretty much across the board. That's the third requirement. Before, this is the buzzword, before transacting customs business in the same, in the name of his principal, custom house broker is required to obtain a valid power of attorney to do so. Recall, this is the old phrase. It has been amended in 1980s, I believe 1984, to instead of custom house broker, we now use the phrase customs, licensed customs broker. So power of attorney is a must. The district permit where you file a drawback claim is not required as long as you have a permit within your municipality. All right. So that's about licensed broker with the power of attorney. All right. How are we being tested on this stuff? So the table lists the documents and the table lists the other. So what about the column two people, right? Who is the column two person? Any individual legally authorized to bind person or entity with whom the documents are executed. So legally authorized to bind, so it would be like an attorney, right? Who represents the company, they do the filing. Or it would be, it can be an attorney of law, at law, or attorney in fact. Of course, since engaging in customs business as a licensed customs broker requires a license, this may be a problem for attorney in fact who is unlicensed, right? Because this is a regulated field. Let's take a look at how the customs examiners test you on this. Which party does not have the authority to sign drawback documents? All right, so we're dealing with pretty much column one. A licensed broker without power of attorney, right? So you must have a power of attorney, period. Right, so A will not give you authority if you don't have power of attorney, because power of attorney is operative instrument which gives you authority to act. It must be obtained, as we saw, prior to engaging in customs business before 141-46. All right, so since we're looking for the one that's not A is our answer choice, but let's move on and analyze others. Any employee of business entity with power of attorney, so there is a power of attorney. Any employee of the business entity, in a way, yes. However, keep in mind that if any employee is an officer, right, then that's all right. What about the manager level, right? What if it's the accounting manager, right? As long as that power of attorney is provided, right, and that employee is authorized, then that's all right. The problem here, and this has come up, before in the customs broker responsibilities questions, that power, there may be several powers of attorney. One power of attorney may be given by the client to the broker, corporate broker, to transact customs business. Another power of attorney can be given to employee to transact customs business on behalf of a company, if that employee is not an officer. So it's kind of ambiguous, but this one is obviously not correct. So under the best answer rule, you could make the argument. I doubt that you will succeed. But just keep in mind that ambiguity is out there. an individual acting on his or her own behalf, that is always the case. If you do not need the licensed broker, if you know the stuff, you go by all means, go ahead and do it. A full partner of a partnership, yes. Remember, if it's a limited partnership, a limited partner may do that if that limited partner, that limitation of that limited partner is to engage in customs business and that partner is licensed. The owner of a sole proprietorship. So I hate to form legal entities. Let's say I do not want to deal with this corporate paperwork, with this tax filings, etc., etc. I just want to do a simple business. So yes, sole proprietorship may be the way to go. So without forming a legal entity, I can file DBA doing business as, right? I will do this as under my personal license, not under the corporate license umbrella. So the owner of sole proprietorship will do.